most of you are back. So I'm going to talk a little bit about choosing a great WordPress plugin. I'm not going to specifically tell you which plugin is good for which categories. If you want to know that, come and ask me later specifically what you need. I'll tell you the best plugin to use. But I'm telling you how to search for a good plugin. I think that's important. So number one golden rule is don't read the 20 WordPress plugins you must install and go install it all. Because there's a likely chance that 19 of the 20 you don't need. There's a great chance that 5 out of the 20 are insecure. And there's a really great chance, not so great chance, but 3 out of the 20 is going to crash your website. So don't do that. Choose the plugins that you really need. And I'm going to say a really unpopular sentence, but if you are going to need something, check whether Jetpack does it. So Jetpack has a not so good reputation online, because mostly political, that they are very bloated. But the truth is actually quite far from that, because I actually look at the code. So if you don't activate a certain function of Jetpack, it doesn't take up any resource. So Jetpack can do various stuff like check your web statistics, auto-publish content that you post on your website to Facebook, to Twitter. It could speed up images by putting the images on the WordPress.com servers. It could protect you from brute force attacks. And brute force attacks are actually quite important to know about. So for example, what happens is that on average, likely your website gets attacked about 50,000 times a day. You just don't know it. So they are trying out your passwords. If you use your name and then 1234, likely eventually you get hacked. And even if you get hacked, some of them are so good, they don't let you know that you're hacked. So this one prevents brute force attacks. They realize that someone's trying to guess your password or some bot is trying to guess your password, they'll protect it. So there's a lot of very useful functionality that you will find in various other plugins. But if you can, check whether Jetpack has it. Usually it does. If you want to see related posts, it does have that as well. There's actually more than this. It's like 30, 40 functions. Go ahead and look at it. And plugins on WordPress.org. And bear in mind, you cannot install plugins from anywhere. You can install plugins from codekenyon.com.net. You can install plugins from various other WordPress agencies. But plugins on WordPress.org are checked for security. So there's about, like I said, 43,000 plugins. We check them all. And whenever there's a security issue that affects everyone, we actually get the developer to fix it immediately. We send an email to all developers. So if you have checking, I recently posted out on Facebook HTTP proxy vulnerability. We actually just blasted out email, I think, a few hours ago to tell all WordPress developers that this is an issue. Go update your plugins. And if it so happens that actually there is a serious security flaw with a plugin, either we will force update it ourselves or we will just remove it from downloading for a while. So this is what I'm saying is that if you download it from WordPress.org, they're usually safe. Experiences on other sites like ThemeForest or CodeKenyon, it can vary quite greatly. Now this is the case because there are two cases, there are two important points. Number one is that if you download a theme for ThemeForest, usually there are one theme does 100 different kind of websites. You can do any kind of look that you want, but this usually means that there's very bloated code. And because they are trying to support, for example, the sales of some of these themes goes up to 50,000 sales. They sell only $50 each, but they sell to 50,000 people. And each of these people, they have support at least for a year. So they end up having to do the support for this. They don't have a lot of time to look into the code or redo some of the code they know they are not so good. So, but of course, on this website, you do find some good ones, but the chances are not very great. So what I'm saying is that if you need a plugin, look through the WordPress.org plugin repository as well. Even though they are free, it doesn't mean they're not so good. Now, take for example, WooCommerce is now the biggest e-commerce platform. It covers about 36% e-commerce websites around the world. The next closest is Magento Enterprise at 7%. Shopify covers about 1% or so of e-commerce websites. So WooCommerce is available on WordPress repo for free. It's a great system that's available for free. So go ahead and check out WordPress.org for plugins. So now I'm going to cover a little bit on how you can search for the plugin that you want, because honestly, the search on the WordPress admin not working as well as we want it. So you can use make sure you use the appropriate search terms. Don't go and write best SEO, because someone's going to write his plugin and call it best SEO, and you're not going to get what you want. If you have a WordPress website, you likely use one of these two SEO plugins, either the Yaos SEO plugin or the all-in-one SEO plugin. So, but if you notice that when I search best SEO, I don't get anything related to that at all. So another key thing is that you will likely get better results even though it's using similar systems on WordPress.org itself. So when you're looking for a plugin, try to search on WordPress.org first, get the name, then use your WordPress admin to install it. That's likely going to be a better chance for you to find the ones that you want. So like for example like this, if I search for SEO and I select the tag keyword from the drop down, I'll get the specific ones that I want. Because if I don't know what's Yaos SEO and I don't know what's all-in-one SEO pack, at least when I search for this, I see these are the top people, there's a lot of reviews, there's 1 million active installs, and last updated quite recently. Yeah, so you'll get this, but if you notice the last one, doesn't get me that. So use the correct keywords and be specific to what you want. Don't use words like best or use words like the and so on. Yeah. So if you have been following the WordPress project, we're actually updating the WordPress.org repository to something newish. This is the new design that's being beta tested. Now, what does this mean? This also means that your search experience is going to be improved. So when you search for SEO without having to select the tag keyword and stuff like that, you get to find the specific SEO plugins that are popular. A few things that you can look out for. So when you click into a plugin itself, make sure you check whether they are compatible. If they are compatible up to the latest WordPress version, then check when did they last update it. Now, here's the thing. They do not need to always update it. If they've created a plugin that works great for a long time, don't need to check that. But I think one of the most important things is check how many active installs. So like Yaos SEO has about 1 million plus active installs. Active install means that people are using that on the active websites that are being tracked by WordPress. So that at least you know there's 1+ million websites that are using it, no issues. Yeah. Check the ratings. And actually with WordPress, we realized that it's not so much that you should check about many 5-star ratings. Check on how they reply to their 1-star rating. The thing about people, right, and especially Singaporeans, is that only when things go wrong, then they complain. Yeah, not a lot of people go say, great plugin, thank you for the work, or I'm going to give you a donation. They won't say that. When it's all good, they won't say nothing. And when it doesn't work for the website, they say, hey, your thing broke my site. You guys are some expletive. And things like that. I've seen really terrible ones. I've seen people curse people's families just for providing a free plugin. But you see, the thing about it is that how do you judge whether the developer is good or whether he's created a good product? How does he reply to such people? Yeah. So look at the 1-star replies, and you notice that Yaos SEO being the most popular plugin for SEO. Anyway, the name is actually Juice, but it's pronounced Yaos, so that's why he calls it Yaos SEO. But more importantly, they have a team that actually deals with the 1-star people. And if you use another plugin called the Events Calendar, I like that plugin a lot, you can go in there and scream and then bloody murder, but they'll still ask you what's wrong, and could you explain to us what went wrong, blah, 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 and they'll follow up. Now, this shows they really care about the product and are willing to listen to criticism. And they're going to improve the product based on what you say. So look at the 1-star replies, not just the 5-star ones. Another one, look at how many support threads they have solved within the last 2 months. So if they have done a lot, at least they are answering questions, that's very important. But this is not just a sole indicator, because it could very well be like Yaos SEO, they don't actually do main support here. They have their own support forums on their own website, and they bring people there. So, but a lot of other plugins, they use the WordPress.org forums. You can just look through how many people are using it. And how many people are getting the answers answered. Yeah. So before you choose that, remember that in all the websites you do, especially business websites, you have liability. So any plugin that you use, you should be able to trust that it's going to be supported for the next few years, at least. Because WordPress is going to be supported for a long time, but the plugins, not necessary. So look through your track record. If it looks also like that out of 10 support requests, you've answered 10, even though it's only 10 support requests, could be they're doing a very good job, no one needs any support, but they answered a great deal of them, then this is someone that you can trust because you know that they're going to talk to you. Another point is that check whether they have extensive description, FAQ, screenshots, all this. The more information they put in, this shows the more they trust on their products. If you go to a plugin page and everything is empty, then I wouldn't install that. Yeah, even if they have a really fanciful name. So generally, this is how you check for a good plugin. And if you actually just look at, if you really only want to look at one point, look at the active installs. If there's a lot of active installs, usually go mine. Yeah, go for it. So I mentioned this just now again about checking through a host. Now, when you download a plugin, you might want to check whether this plugin is going to screw up your site. So after you activate it, maybe run it through the P3 plugin. So if you run this through, by the way, this is built by GoDaddy, one of their really great contributions, if I remember correctly. Run it through and see whether this new plugin that you've activated, how does it affect your site? Does it create an additional load of 2 more seconds on the website? Or does it not? Yeah, so it's important to do that. You will get this kind of a graph, and you should really do that for every plugin that you install. Because, for example, if I actually recently, not recently, a year ago, I downloaded this plugin called User Pro. Did exactly what I want, but it also did another 50 things that I didn't want. But this was okay, but I thought, you know, I could deactivate the things that I didn't want. So I installed it, and then it basically created, and I didn't notice it until very late. So one day, I thought, hey, why is this client-side loading additional 2 seconds? It's no joke, it's 2 seconds. I ran this through. I found out it was this plugin creating a 2 seconds load. And then after I tracked through the code, I realized that there are some portions that were not written well. So I wrote it to them and asked them to fix it. I don't think they really did. But the point is, this helped me figure it out. Then actually wasting about a few hours trying to figure out what's wrong with the plugins that we use. So with WordPress.org, you get a good selection of plugins that you can use. And the truth is, even if there's a paid alternative to these plugins, it could be very well that they say this plugin has a professional version. But they will usually have a free version inside the WordPress.org repository. So any serious WordPress developer who wants real business will likely put a free version of their plugin inside there. So try to look through that first. That's usually a good mine. And when you use a plugin and you decide, for example, like at Yelp SEO, there's actually a premium service, and you decide that I want to subscribe to a premium service, you can do so. But the free version is always available first. Yeah. So I'm going to go back to this. So in the future, the WordPress repository is going to be like this. And you click in, actually, it's going to be a slightly different look than this. It's under beta testing, but you can actually go to it via wordpress.org/plugins-wp. I'll put it on the meetup.com later, and I'll actually put it in the slides later. You can download as well. If you go to that is actually a better experience right now. You can use it to search better. You can find the relevant plugins, because right now, if you search via the admin using not necessarily the real keywords or not, you get something like 300 plus active installs. And usually, this more than likely is not what you are looking for. Last thing I want to say is that plugins on these services usually offer a lot of things, but they are not always security audited. Yeah, and they are not always light on the hosting plan. So unless you are planning to pay from $12 hosting to $100 hosting, don't go to these guys first. Go to WordPress.org. Now, if you cannot find something exactly what you need, then go to these guys. So that's all from me for selecting a good WordPress plugin. really the key takeaway is that WordPress.org plugin has 43,000 plugins. You will get what you want. You cannot find it, use the correct search terms. You cannot find it, use the new beta plugin repository. In the future, actually, those searches will be weighted and so on, so you'll get better relevant results. But we are working towards that. So, do you have any questions? Anyone wants to learn which plugin they need to use for which purposes? Yeah. Anyone? Do you have any questions? Yeah. Sorry?
That would be great.
Share generally, if you need SEO, use Charles SEO. I know him, but I don't earn any money from him. If you are in the e-commerce system, use WooCommerce. They are the market leader by far, not just within WordPress. If you're using a contact form, there are free contact forms such as Contact Form 7. Incidentally, with WordCamp, one of the speakers probably might be the Contact Form 7 author. Yeah, might be. He submitted something. So Contact Form 7 is free. Again, you can download from WordPress.org. In terms of any other categories you want to hear about?
Custom post types.
Custom post types. I actually write custom post types. Yeah, basically use ACF. Yeah, advanced custom fields. Because the person who wrote it, Scott Clark, anyway, he's a pretty nice guy. Yeah, so usually I try to judge based on if I meet a person and I speak to him, I think he's a nice guy. I like his plugin. But I've used ACF before. Actually, what Zion is asking about is that with WordPress, actually, you can create custom fields. So for example, you have created a portfolio page, but you want to create multiple portfolio items. So either you install a plugin that does that, or you create a custom post type. So a page is a post type, a post is also a post type. Now don't get confused about that, but just think of containers, there are many containers. So you could very well create new customized containers that store the requirements or the data you want. So in a portfolio item, maybe you want to store your customer name. You don't want to put everything in the same box. You want to store it separately because you want to print it or you want to put it in a theme in a separate position. So you could do that through advanced custom fields. Yeah. Or generally just custom fields. So advanced custom fields is a plugin that does it for free. Yeah. There's also, I think, post types, the plugin itself, and post views that does that. They are actually quite popular.
Types is great for creating custom post types, and then that's it. The one where you edit a post and then the various fields, right? The interface ACF is much better. Yeah. So actually, it's comfortable.
Yeah. Well, I'm kind of a write it yourself kind of guy. So anyway, that's a good one. Any other categories?
One thing, on the red about the plugins thing, I've been noticing a few plugins that are abandoned by the author.
Yeah.
Then someone else takes over it.
Yeah.
And then they use it. The only update that they do is that they will put like next screens that encourage you to subscribe to some other service.
Yeah.
So like, I'm wondering if that's against the plugin info guidelines or something.
You see, the great thing about having 43, okay, the bad thing about having 43,000 plugins is that a lot of them eventually get abandoned. They may still work. And one of the more popular plugins is called Regenerate Thumbnails, written by, what's his name? I remember his name is Viper007. But he's a great guy also from Automatic. But anyway, he wrote that many years ago, and only, I think, last year he wrote a new version. But before that, he didn't update it for 3 or 4 years. It still worked, because it's such a great plugin. So there are plugins that eventually get abandoned and don't work. Then people take over them. So one of the ways is actually that you can actually email the plugin team and take over. But then we check. We check, you have to actually write a new update that's substantially different. We'll check with the old authors whether that's okay. So when it passes through us, no issues. Now the bad thing is that when it doesn't pass through us, for example, Valentine writes a plugin, and then I want to take over, I'm a scheming person, I'm going to take over and I'm going to put a subscribe to our premium service kind of thing, but actually I'm offering you nothing special. And if he sells it to me, or if he just gives it to me for free, there's nothing we at WordPress can do. Something you have to look out for, but the thing is, they are still not allowed to add in insecure code. They are still not allowed to add in anything illegal. It might be in a moral gray spot, but we are not open. WordPress is supposed to be open source and free. Free meaning in freedom, so we are not going to control the gray areas. Yeah.
So there are two things. I think one of them is that if it's on SVN, all of them are on SVN, right? You can get the older version without all the next screens.
Yeah.
And second thing is anything on the plugin repo is GPL.
Yes.
So you can fork it. And you can create your own version of.
You can.
Got contaminated by next screens.
Yes. Yeah, you can. So if you actually go, I'm not sure whether I have the screenshots. Let me check. Yeah, if you look at a plugin, you can click the developer button, or even if you click in, you can still click developer button. You actually have a list of older versions of the plugin to download. So it might be the very case that you're using older version of WordPress and then you can't update for some reason, but I do encourage you to update. You could find an older version of the plugin that may work for your older version of WordPress. You could do that, or as Valentine has pointed out, if someone has maybe changed your plugin for the worse, you can download older version. And that will help. Yeah. Yes.
Do you have any plugin for this translation as well as multi languages?
Basically, the market leader is WPML, WP multi language.
Yeah. What about Polylang?
Okay, Polylang and Xtranslate, they are both iffy, meaning that if they work, it works. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work, because WPML is designed in such a way that it plays really well with any plugin, or most plugins I use, most themes I use, because they're using very strict WordPress standards. Not all WordPress plugins, even if they are on our WordPress repo, right, are designed specifically to our standards. So they may work for, say, 90% of sites. Maybe they don't work for some 10%. And the thing about WPML is that it's free. It's not free. It's very cheap. Yeah, it's about $20 or something like that. They also have a translation service behind, meaning that you can actually hire translators once you've installed a plugin. And they have an ecosystem where different translators will actually bid for the job. Yeah. So if you create a multi-language system, right, this translator know that you're going to use it on their systems, so everything is connected, everything is linked. It's perfect for you. And the thing about WPML is that they're likely the only translation plugin that I trust. Yeah. So just go to wpml.org, I think. Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Any questions? Yeah,
what
please.
About
for backup? So backup-wise, there are two plugins that I like. But one is Updraft Plus. Updraft. D-R-A-F-T. Yeah. Plus. Yeah, the plus is a nice word, but actually it's not plus. So it's just a nice word. But anyway, Updraft Plus is not a professional one. It's free. They of course have a professional version, but you don't need to use that if you don't want to. Good thing about that is that you can actually back up everything to, say, Dropbox or Amazon Web Services or Google Drive, and Microsoft Storage as well, things like that. So remember, when you back up, the key thing to notice is that don't end up backing up your backups only to the web server, because if someone hacks into it, they're going to delete your backups and you have nothing left. Yeah. So it's good to have a backup automatically run and backup to Dropbox. Yeah. Then you have a copy in your computer, in Dropbox services, and maybe back in your web server as well. Yeah. So Updraft Plus does that, automated backups. You can run it maybe every 2 weeks for files and every 2 days or 1 day for your database, and it'll back it out all for you automatically. That's Updraft Plus. The other one is Backup WordPress. It's made by HumanMade, another one of the big WordPress agencies. Very simple, you just press a button and it'll back it up for you. And then when it's done, they'll email you a link to download the backup if you need to. If not, you just store on your web server. But that also means that you should download the backup. If I remember, I haven't used Backup WordPress for a while. They might back up to Dropbox now, I don't know. But these are the two that I usually trust. Yeah. Yeah. Anyone from back? Any questions? Okay, so I'm just going to do... Yes?
Sorry, this is not about plugin, but using the plugin for... Is there any special trick, right?
Yeah.
To find
forum discussion of specific plugin only. I don't understand WordPress such a popular site, right, but there isn't such function. So.
Okay. To search for, no.
Because honestly, our search system sucks. Yeah, I actually discussed this within the team chat last night that we really need an Elasticsearch server. But anyway, we are working on that. First thing is because our forums, our plugin system, our themes, they are all integrated and kind of like a mismatch of work. Yeah, we're so busy writing WordPress, we basically build something that works. Yeah, but in terms of that, how they exchange data and stuff like that, not very done very well. So the only way to find plugin specific threads is actually go into the plugin page itself and click on the support page. Then you get a full page of related. For example, you look for Yelp SEO. If you click on this, actually, you know what? I'm just going to show it to you. Okay, I'm glad I did not have any web sets open. Okay. So if you use this, if you realize that we're actually using Google's custom search, yeah, mainly because our search is not very good. We are improving that. So the only way for you to get specific, say, Yelp SEO plugin threads is click on support. Yeah.
Yeah, but the problem is I have to browse the page.
Yes, sort of. We are working on improving it. Through number one, the forum system is being rewritten. This is actually one of blockers because of how everything is encrypted. This is actually version 1 of BB Press. We are moving on to version 2 because I don't know how, if you notice, there's actually millions of posts per week. Yeah, and the tough part is that we have built a lot of custom tools to deal with that, and the custom tools need to be ported over to version 2, so we've been writing code for that as well. This is going to be improved, but right now it's not good. Yeah. Yes.
Actually, use search operators to provide Google SDK. Like, if you type like site colon.
Yeah, that was actually the follow up question.
Yeah.
You can anything that works with Google search will work with our Google custom search as well. Yeah. So if you say, but you see, again, the links will be not necessarily curated by us. So you will not get a nice listing that you get in typical forums specific to what you want. You get a list of what Google thinks is correct. Yeah, that's the best it can do right now. It's being worked on. It will take some time. Yeah. Any questions?
Forum.
Yeah.
Forum.
Yes. BB Press. Yeah. Because the core engineers are also working on BB Press, so it's the most best integrated WordPress. It's not going to be as pretty as you would to have, say, like Envision Board or what's that, or Power, whatever. But anyway, or the PHP BB. It's not going to be as pretty as that. But because it's WordPress, you can download WordPress BB Press theme, and you can make it look nice. But in terms of functionality, it's quite there, yeah. So BB Press, and if you want to create a social network, use Buddy Press, yeah. Yeah.
You can create a social network.
Yeah, if you need to have user profiles, you want to people add friends and stuff like that. You want to create a social network, you can use Buddy Press or community, yeah. Hey.
What about WordPress
security? Security-wise, choose the correct plugins and themes. Okay, but the truth is, there's nothing out there that can really say I'm going to secure your website. Mm. But they can scan your files, yeah, and so on. But usually, what happens is that by the time they catch something, you're already hacked. Yeah. So number one, Jetpack's brute force plugin that protects against brute force. They'll prevent people from guessing a password. Usually the truth is, this is how most people get hacked. They use their name plus 1234. They use their birth dates. Anything that I can scrape off online, right, about you, I can probably use it to test for your password. Yeah. So if you use a complex password, you don't have to ever worry. So password plugins such as Clef, WPClef, C-L-E-F, allows you, just going to show you a little bit on my client website. So we have this plugin called Clef. So So it doesn't use passwords, it uses my phone, so unless you cut off my hand and get my thumbprint to open the phone, uses this kind of a microsystem, it's asking for a thumbprint, and can scan the thumbprint. Yeah, that's why, let me log out. Yeah, and then you can scan the barcode and it will log in. Yeah, so that's one. Use two-factor authentication, whether it's using Clef is not so much two-factor, it's a different way of logging in, or you can use Google's Authenticator. Yeah, it's available as a free app, and you can rejoice that in core we're actually putting in two-factor authentication soon. Yeah, but soon can be a while. Yeah, it's being worked on, trust me, it's being worked on. you can use Sucuri, Sucuri. They have a plugin that scans your files. For example, if your files change, Sucuri. Sucuri. Yeah, Sucuri. It will help you check through your files whether it's been changed and stuff like that. There's also iTeam Security. I have not used that before, but they are very popular. I've met a guy once before, and he seems nice. That's that. But in terms of the truth is, to really secure a website, make sure you have a good web host. Make sure you use only plugins that you want. Always keep everything updated. Usually you're fine. The people who get hacked are people who don't ever update their sites. Use poor passwords. Yeah, that's I would say covers about 90% of how people get hacked. Good.
With Jetpack, yeah. Is there a way around having clients setting up their own accounts and then providing that information? So that's the one bugbear about installing that.
Oh, you mean connecting to WordPress.com?
Yeah.
Yeah. With Jetpack specifically, no way around that. But there are other plugins that people have built to emulate the same behavior. For example, Jetpack offers an image carousel function. So when you upload a gallery, if you notice the default WordPress function, when you click on the image, it's actually take you to another page with a bigger image. But if you wanted a pop-up, a light box kind of a thing to show the image in a nicer view, Jetpack allows that, but you have to connect to WordPress.com. There is a plugin called WordPress, Jetpack Carousel without Jetpack, something like that. Yeah, I can't remember the exact name, but it does that. So there are a few plugins that actually emulate the Jetpack behavior without having you to connect to WordPress.com, because Jetpack requires that. The reason it requires that is because, for example, it has a key function that like site stats. It uses all of WordPress.com's their servers, there are hundreds of servers, to power what you need without actually exhausting your server or your web host. That's actually one reason. So if you're actually having to clean up spam, make sure that by default Akismet is installed. You also need a WordPress.com account with that as well. I think a Kismet account, but it's basically a WordPress.com account. That cleans spam, and it's actually learning. So WordPress.org actually has that as well. So it learns let's say we all have WordPress websites. This guy spams my website every single day, and I click delete, 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 spam, spam, spam. And your website will learn this behavior because it's all controlled on WordPress.com servers. Yeah. And then your website will automatically block this person without you having to deal with it. So that's how WordPress.com helps you, whether it's through Jetpack or through Akismet. Yeah. Fit?
So that means if you use Jetpack, you don't need the Akismet?
No, there's separate thing. Akismet is specifically for spam. Yeah. So Jetpack is for various other services. So you Akismet is installed basically by default with WordPress. So you just need to activate and sign up for a free account. So Akismet is free. If you decide you want to pay money, you can as well. Yeah, they allow you to select that. Yeah, no worries. Yeah. But of course, if I think if you have an enterprise level of system, you still want to use Akismet. And bear in mind, WordPress.org receives millions of views. It's running on Akismet. It's proven to work. One day you're running for a Fortune 500 company who needs this kind of level of services, you can recommend Akismet and pay a sum to WordPress.com and they will support you as well. Yeah. Any last questions? I'll take one more. Yes.
There are so many plugins, right?
Yes.
But then if we do not want to kind of like slow down our WordPress.
Yeah.
So it's like, why is recommended? Like maybe just a few?
Use a cache plugin. My favorite is WP Super Cache. built by automatic, because you don't have super cache, because you don't have to understand how it works. There's another very popular one called W3 Total Cache, but you have to understand how it works. There's a lot of settings. Yeah. So if you just use WP Super Cache, install it, enable it, okay, yeah, set up. You don't need to touch anything. So your cache, it will cache everything that you need, so that it doesn't need to go back to the database. It doesn't need to go through PHP again. It will run it through a cache system. This way, when people go to your website, it uses less resource on your website. It makes your site look like it looks faster as well. But if you install a lot of plugins that you don't need, eventually it's going to come to a point where either you need a developer or you need better web hosting. So just be specific about what you need. Don't install things that you don't actually need. Yeah. Okay, great. So I'm just going to do one last thing, talking about WordCamp. You have all got this flyer. So WordCamp is a not-for-profit conference. And the thing is, we are all doing is just to promote WordPress. So there are two tracks. One is the developer and business track. The other is the user and education track. So be very clear that if you're a user and you're not techie, you're not a tech person, don't worry. If you come to this, you still get talks that says, shows you exactly how you should optimize your WordPress website, what kind of plugins you choose, how do you do SEO, how do you do marketing, things like that. Maybe even a little bit of a design principles, stuff like that. If you're a developer, you get really specific developer topics, core WordPress development. We are getting talks from all around the world, from Japan, Vietnam, Indonesia. There's a guy coming from UK, there's a guy coming from Switzerland. Some people from Japan, actually, two or three of them from Japan, but speak English, so don't worry. So international speakers with wide WordPress experiences. And when you go there, it's not just about the talks, because actually when you get your breaks, there's going to be sponsors out there who are going to show you their products, show you their web hosting services, so you can actually have a face-to-face discussion with this web host and ask them, why should I choose you? Yeah. And GoDaddy, yeah. Yeah, I can't remember. I'm supposed to remember this, but I don't remember. Yeah, general admission is only for $40. Please just go for it. And I'd like to let you know there's a nice after party afterwards. So the after party is not just for drinks. The main important thing is that you get to meet a lot of WordPress people. If you're doing a WordPress business or you're going to set up a website, you want to meet a partner, you want to meet a developer, or you want to meet the general WordPress people to talk about the things that you want to propose to your company or to yourself, these are the places that you meet these such people. Actually, a lot of these things, a lot of the WordPress WordCamp sponsorship and things that we got this year was actually decided when I went to the WordCamp in the US. And then at the after party, I talked to a lot of people and got a lot of things settled. So this is the kind of connections you get to make at the WordCamp itself. So I'm hoping that I'm counting maybe about 20 plus 30 people today. That all of you go home and sign up with the discount code that Valentine has given you. It's only a one-day event, 6 September, back here.